Are you a video editor that has clients or multiple clients, or you are in a company that has teams that needs to review your videos, but you really don't have a great way of being able to share the videos and have a one central place for people to leave comments? My colleague and friend, Gord Isman and I, are going to share with you a new TechSmith product called Video Review. Gord, welcome. And why don't you tell everybody really quick about who you are, and we'll get right into the product review and take it away.
Thank you, Naomi. It's Gord Isman here, as you mentioned, and I am a person that does a lot of video editing and creating. Plus, I also educate on YouTube on all things about video, as well as online video marketing. And I am an educator for the most part, and I coach people on how to succeed in using video. And that's why I'm very excited for us to have this discussion today. And, you know, people can find me on YouTube at youtube.com/GordIsman.
I'm very excited about this product. You and I have beta tested it. One central location, it's a lot easier for people to leave replies and comments. And I'm ready to dive in. Are you ready?
Absolutely.
You can start a 30-day free trial and just test it out, which is really great. You would just click on your 30-day free trial, and then just follow the breadcrumbs. Put in your email address, click next, just fill in the information. Once you've signed up for it and gone through that process, you will then come into the dashboard that they use here. Gord, let's go over a couple of the things they have here.
Sure. So basically, the goal is to share a video for review. So there's kind of two roles, and one is called a content owner, and that would be the person that's set up in the software that's uploading content into the service. So this is a service that's based in the cloud. And then you have reviewers, and you can invite reviewers to review the video. And what's very cool is you can have up to 15 people to participate in the review of each video. And there's a ceiling of 10 videos. But by the way, it's not just videos. It can also be JPEG or PNG images. So what's cool about this is, you know, the assets that you would use to go into, you know, for example, a video, you can pretty much review. Either it's inside the content and what you've got created in an MP4 file, because that's the type that's supported, or whether it's like a PNG or JPEG. So, you know, you can share the content and invite people to review.
Great. Let me go ahead and show everyone how easy it is to load a video and to invite someone. So all you need to do is click on the start review and drag the video or the image into the section here. And then you give a title, we'll just call it test video. You put a review date so that your reviewers know by what date that they need to give you feedback. Let's go ahead and say the 24th. You need to be prompt, Gord. Hi, Gord, please review. Go ahead and click on next.
For demonstration purposes and time for this tutorial, I have uploaded a highly compressed video. The video in this tutorial will appear highly pixelated for you. However, in normal uploading circumstances, you will upload a full high definition video file at standard compression for reviewers to watch and comment.
Then you type in the person's email address, add. You invite up to 15 individuals. Click on invite, and it sends out the invite. And while you're waiting for the reviewer, you can look at the video. So what happens is the email is now going to go to Gord, and Gord's going to share his screen and show the process of becoming a reviewer and how to be a reviewer.
Okay, so here we are in my email, and I got the request from Naomi. It's from TechSmith. It says video review, and I need to start it. So we click on the start, and I've got the Naomi had the version of the light theme. I'm actually looking at it as the dark theme. We could toggle it back and forth between those two. So now, in essence, she's emailed me this and I need to look at her video. So I'm just going to, I can play for a bit and, you know, then decide what kind of comments or feedback I want to give. So let's just enter something in a second. I'm just going to play for a few seconds first. So I just wanted to show playing the video for a bit. And now at wherever this point is in the timeline, I'm gonna add a comment for feedback. I'm just gonna ask first off something as general as this: should we be doing square video for this project? So as you see, I press enter, and on the top right now, my comment as a reviewer appears, and it even says here at 16 seconds. That's the exact time spot on the, as you can see on the timeline. And now it's there for others, and there could be other reviewers and the content owner to give feedback. So again, I could enter another one. Let's just say we move the video along to another point. And as you can see now, the point that I had already entered a comment on has a mark on the timeline here. So now we're here as we go along, and I'm going to say, let's say I had something else or more feedback to give, I could add another comment in relationship to where we are here. And just saying, so I did a submit. Now you see there's a second comment there with the timestamp, and again, reply, like, or edit. So now I'm going to pass this back to Naomi, and you're going to see how the system works, because she will have now received that information.
And you will see that Gord's comments are right here. So if I wanted to reply to his comment, I can just add a reply here and say, yes, this is for Facebook and Instagram. And then submit. Now, when Gord put in his comments and when I reply, we'll receive email notifications that there's a reply. And then I might go ahead and reply here and say, good point. And this would be an example of a reviewer could make suggestions, and we could say yes or no and give several feedback. As a team, you're having a lot of feedback, and that will give you as a video editor sufficient information of where you have to make the edits and only have to do it once and not have to keep making, oh, this little edit and this little edit, etc. The other thing here, if I wanted to add a comment right here, let's move it over a little. Let's say, it doesn't matter what it says. I'm just wanting to demonstrate that what you can do here, they have a draw. So I can also say that I want to point this out so that it stands out when I am giving my feedback, and then go ahead and submit this. And you can use any of these draw tools that you would want. I'm just showing it here.
Okay.
It's not doing it for
some reason. Oh, there it is. But there's an arrow.
Oh, it's up there.
Yeah, you just have to move it around.
Okay. And then all I have to do is go ahead and click on submit. Let me pass it back off to you, Gord.
Okay, so now we'll go in and take a look and see what additional email I got. So Naomi did two updates. And so the first one she did was, yes, this is for Facebook and Instagram. And the second email I got, she said, good point. So I can just go in for either one and see here also that what's cool is the full comment detail is here and the time reference point. So I'm going to click visit now. And it brings me back into the application, the video review application. And just to show you, I could go straight to the point that she had, or I can actually go to any point on the timeline where the information is. And I'm doing it by bouncing on the timeline by pressing on the timeline, or you have this nice left and right arrow mechanism that goes strictly to the points where review details or comments have been put. So in the last one, she put on those nice drawing points. And you see right here, no matter what point we're on, it highlights the appropriate comment area to focus on. So now I'm on the last one. It says 3 of 3. Should we keep the text up here or change to an icon? And I'm going to say I'm going to say. And I clicked enter. So as you can see, again, my comment is now, my reply is nested inside this particular time point at 45 seconds on the timeline.
Okay. And it is a really simple and easy way for people to work as a team and not have to keep doing emails back and forth and not actually seeing the video as the other person is seeing it. With those timestamps, you're able to know exactly the point that the reviewer is speaking about and making the changes.
Yeah, I was just going to add one other thing. Mm-hmm. And that is what I like about the possibilities here is that you're not also dealing with having to continuously upload changed versions of your video file into something like Dropbox or Google Drive or whatever space that you're going to work with to share the video, because that's what you're doing here is you're utilizing a service that has the video, it's in one place, and there's going to be just the core version of that you're currently editing working on for review. So right. It just eliminates a lot of risks with people going astray with getting versions out of whack in terms of what they may have emailed or stored on those other kinds of cloud service drives. I'll pass back to you now, Nick.
Okay, thank you. Okay, one thing I wanted to show, okay, I'm going to change this back because I don't like the dark. So what you can see here is there are also, you can see all of the reviews, and this just puts every type of review, the review that you might have uploaded, or if you're reviewing for somebody else. If, under the My Reviews, these are only the videos that you have uploaded and are asking for reviewers. Or you can look at the Shared With Me. And these will be all the videos that have been shared with you that you're responsible or have been asked to review. Now, the one thing that you will notice is that you cannot, if someone has shared a video with you to review, you cannot delete it. The only person that can delete it is the content owner. So if you wanted to, once everything has been reviewed, and you no longer need the video up there, or you've reached your 10 videos allowed in the area, you can click on the options here and simply delete or export your comments. So it would be a good idea to go ahead and export your comments so that you have a record of everything that was said about the video before the final version. And then you can go ahead and delete. And then when you click on delete review, you can say download review data and just tell it where you would like to save the file. And I'll just say desktop for right now. And then you can delete the file. Very simple platform, doesn't make it complex and will make it very easy for anybody to use.
You know, like a very common model now that's used for companies because they outsource a lot of the editing. You know, they have a client that needs to be able to see the video if the editors or somebody runs into trouble and they need some feedback. So it's nice, conveniently shared in one place through the review process, only having to work with the one that's already stored there. That's a huge time saver in terms of execution as well.
I have this exactly what you're speaking of. I have a client in Costa Rica that I edit her videos for, and many times with the other system that we were using, she would have to email me and say, at 2:21, please do this. At 3:22, do this. At 4:12, please do this. And this way, by using this, we'll be able to communicate. I'll be able to look at exactly the points on the video that she wants me to change or adjust.
What I think is interesting is that when I would do this before, I would do an online screen share session with someone, for example, if I needed immediate feedback, but they're in there oftentimes I'm inside the editor with all the noise of all the other stuff going on there. So this is intentionally not an edit environment. It's meant just for review. So it cuts out all that distraction. And I think, you know, that makes it cleaner and easier for the reviewer who's typically not technical and doesn't want to look at stuff like that. So
that's a very valid point, because there's a lot of individuals out there that are technologically challenged. And this is just so much easier of watching the video, put your cursor right here where you want it to stop and put a comment. Watch the video, put your cursor right here, leave a comment.
Yeah, exactly. Full audit trail of the comments and feedback. So, you know, if someone had to scrutinize, how did we end up here?
Right. I hope everybody enjoyed our review of the TechSmith video review service. I hope that you go ahead and check it out and check out the 30-day trial. Gord and I just love TechSmith products and services. So we'll leave the link in the description below. And if you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below. Until we meet again, have a wonderful day.